Ousmane!
La ilaha illallah.
Ousmane! Ousmane!
Ambaré! La ilallah. Huh? Yes, there's still water. Is coronavirus there? May God help us, Rebbe. Yeah. Yeah. Ah, Allahu Akbar. May God just help us to have the cure to this virus called Corona. It's really disturbing the whole world. Whole world. Countries like China are suffering. Countries like Italy are suffering. God forbid for it to enter inside the Gambia. Before it come, let us do something. May God just help us.
Ousmane! This boy, I've been telling him not to leave this compound, but Ousmane is proving himself so stubborn.
But you meet me in this compound, by the grace of God. Wait, Rek. I don't even know where I put my collar notes. Hello? Hey, Fabakai. Hey, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, I'm fine. How is the family? You see, you don't understand. I'm not leaving my... Anything going to mosque is a problem, my brother. I'm talking to you. Very good. It's all because of this coronavirus. This thing is really disturbing us. In fact, my family, I prefer we all be indoors. If not me and my wife, even my wife, is when she's going to market. If not market issue, I want her to be indoors. Understand? Very good. You have to take care of your family, my brother. This coronavirus is getting serious every now and then. People are dying every second. As I'm talking to you right now, in the world there, outside there, in Europe, China and others, my brother, people are dying. Alhamdulillah, wallahi. You see, all those VDC meetings, they should put a pause to that. Let them stop talking about those. Let's postpone that thing. After this thing, let's overcome this coronavirus, my brother. We cannot leave this thing in the hands of WHO. We leave this in the hands of UNDP, UNICEF, and others. Let's make sure we help them. They're helping us. We have to help ourselves as well. Okay. No problem. Thank you. No problem. Thank you. All right. I will tell him. Fabakari, thank you very much for calling, eh? Yes. Just don't forget to take care of your family because you have to be very cautious about this, okay? Thank you very much, sir. Yeah, an old friend. God is great. Yeah? Fabakari, just went like that into you. Hey!
Wash your hand.
For me to wash my hand.
You have to wash your hand, my brother.
Wash your hands.
No problem.
Yes.
No problem. I will.
Very good.
Is this work now? This is hell loud.
Wash your hands clean.
No problem.
Wash your hands up to the elbow, you'll be fine. Yes.
No, here is okay. Don't worry, here is okay.
Correct.
But Algalo. Algalo, do I don't see you at the mosque?
It's a long story. Imam. Come. It's a long story. Just call some again.
But it's a problem.
It's a problem, guys.
It's a problem.
How are you? I'm fine. No, let's hold it like that. Just sit down, Imam. Sit down.
But I don't understand it.
Just sit down.
You know, you are treating me. I'm not understanding it. Am I having coronavirus?
You see, Imam, you don't understand. It's not I'm treating you because you have coronavirus whatsoever. I'm not suspecting you, in fact. It's because I want us to prevent ourselves. Mm-hmm. Understand? Mm-hmm. Maybe you're not having, but God forbid you have told somebody who's having it outside. I'm just saying so. I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem. Imam, I understand.
This day, today you pay me this visit. Hope all is well.
Sally came to my house.
Sally
Ibrahim.
Okay,
Sally. Sally Ibrahim.
Yes.
We were at the mosque. So he said that he's going to visit in my house because he has a message for me. I said, okay. So he's just from my house. So I decided to come and inform him as the alcalde. And tomorrow, in the morning, we have naming ceremony.
Tomorrow.
And we have to go and grace the occasion.
Okay.
Okay. Hence, I am the imam and you are the alcalo. So we have to go and grace that occasion. So that's why I say, let me pass by and pass the information to you. So you can get prepared. Tomorrow we go in the morning.
Well, imam, thank you very much. I'm sure you might not know the reason why I'm not coming to the Muslim fast. I know you will see me at the Muslim so. Good. The only reason why I'm not even coming to mosque to pray at the mosque, I'm praying in my own house, is because of this coronavirus. This coronavirus is spread everywhere in the world, I can tell you this, imam. And because of that, the government of the Gambia banned all other public gatherings. Schools are closed. There are some poor working places that are closed. Different things are banned. Even Lumos, no Lumos. So I'm sure the naming ceremony, wedding ceremony whatsoever, is inside those things. Now the government says, let's ban this. Why are we putting ourselves into trouble?
How do you expect me, the imam, and you, the alcalo, not to go for that ceremony? If the government will let them ban their office, let them close their office. But they cannot stop us from going for these naming ceremonies and whatsoever. We have to do our activities. How can the government tell us, let us not go to the mosque to prevent ourselves? Does God tell us to prevent ourselves that way? Alcalo, all what I have to tell you is, let us prepare and go for this naming ceremony.
Now the government says, let's ban this. Why are we putting ourselves into trouble? People are outside the WHO. They are ready to help us. They are helping us as I'm talking to you right now. UNDP, UNICEF. There are a lot of organizations outside. They are helping us to cure this coronavirus and to prevent ourselves from it. Why are we now pushing ourselves into it? That naming ceremony, you don't know who might be affected there. Somebody might be there who is affected. You just greet the person. Oh yeah, you see. So let's try to prevent ourselves. Imam, let's, Alcalo, please, when you go talk to Sally, let him postpone that.
Alcalo, all what I have to tell you is, let us prepare and go for this same ceremony.
Imam.
Oh, the people in the community, the way they are going to see you, they will see the other side of you. Imam. I'm telling you.
Imam.
I got your message. For me, as the imam of this community, I am going.
I ask you not to leave this compound. You are leaving this compound. Today I will show you that I'm your father and you don't give back to me. I gave back to you. Imam, please, let's make sure we put things at the right place. I am begging you, imam.
I am going.
Why?
I am very, very disappointed in you today. As the alcalo of this community, you want to go and attend our ceremonies because you say coronavirus. It's not even in the Gambia. No problem. I got your message. I know what to tell our people.
You are going.
I will
be very careful. And I'm begging you, after that naming ceremony, immediately after the naming ceremony, imam, call 1025. Let them attend to you.
Why should I call them?
Because I am sure, even if you are negative, it's necessary for them to attend to you, imam.
Okay.
Let them attend to you.
So this is a clear manifestation that I am having coronavirus.
I'm saying so, I'm sorry.
You are saying it.
I'm not saying so.
No problem.
Just make sure you are clean. Make sure you are negative, please. And
all what I have to tell you is, let me not see inside my mocks. Really? Let me not see inside my mocks. The alcalo of this community. You don't want to attend our naming ceremony. Go on, listen. You are not going for our mocks.
Tell them I am sorry.
No problem. Okay. I cannot
risk the life of my family and I. How can I be attending to naming ceremony when the government is banning public gathering? As an alcalo, in fact.
Not because the alcalo of this community, because of this coronavirus, don't attend our ceremony. What is it? Because of this coronavirus, the people of this community must see this. I cannot get the alcalo of this community. It cannot be possible. I know what to do.
Man, how are you doing?
May I know you, please?
I'm Mr. Jallo.
Mr. Jallo?
A public health officer of Moliba Village.
Ah, yes! Okay.
Yeah, Imam, as I was passing, this is a gesture that I have just seen which I'm really not impressed. And I think I should address it as a youth activist.
What is that?
Yeah, Imam, haven't you heard of this virus called coronavirus?
Coronavirus?
Yes.
I'm just from our police alcalo. We are to attend a naming ceremony tomorrow early in the morning. And he says he's not going for that naming ceremony because of this coronavirus.
Yeah, Imam, don't you think that what your alcalo did was a wise decision? Yeah.
What do you mean?
This coronavirus is a very, very deadly virus and it has been declared as a pandemic. That is, it affects the whole world, the entire universe. Yeah, Imam, as I'm speaking to you now,
yes.
Can you please give a distance of 1 minute?
Yes, 1 minute.
Yes, just give a distance of 1 minute. see you are coughing and you are sneezing. Are those the only complications that you face for now that you are experiencing?
No, sir. I feel very cold inside. And sometimes I find it very difficult to breathe. And I have sore throat too.
Do you sometimes have headache?
Yes, my head aches so much.
Yaima, see all these signs and symptoms that he has just given me. These are all signs and symptoms of coronavirus. Hey, Yaima, as I'm speaking to you now, there are ways and means, there are precautionary measures that can be taken to prevent the spread of this virus.
What are those measures?
One, as you are doing here, social distancing. It's very, very important. You need to respect social distancing. Give 1 meter difference to the person you are speaking to. Yaima, your Alcalo made a decision of not going to that marriage ceremony anymore.
Yes.
It is very, very important because we are to avoid public gatherings. In fact, the government has placed a ban on it and has limited the number to only 10. Yaima, this virus is very, very deadly. Let me lay emphasis on it. As this man is sneezing, he needs to cover his face with his elbow. And also, he should avoid touching his face, like his mouth, his nose, and his ears. Because these are all openings in which the virus can easily penetrate and enter inside the body. Okay. Yaima, we need to practice good sanitary measures. Washing our hands regularly with soap and running water or with hand sanitizers. Okay. Yaima, let me lay emphasis also that this virus is very, very deadly. But if cases like this should be suspected, there is a number to call.
Yes! Can you please call them for us, please?
Let me do that. Hey, the number to call is 1025.
1025.
Free of charge, all GSM operators.
Then do that fast.
Hello? Yes, Mr. Daniel. Good day, sir. This is Mr. Jallo from Oliver Village. Yes, as I'm speaking to you right now, we are at the Bureau of the VDC. And there are 2 suspected cases of coronavirus as I'm speaking to you right now.
Yes!
Yes, it's an emergency. And your urgency is needed right now. Thank you, sir. We'll be waiting for you there. Thank you.
So, are they coming?
Yes, they are coming. They are coming. Okay. I've just called them and they will come and attend to you with immediate effect. Hey. Because if proper treatment also is given, the virus also cannot survive long in the body. Oh. Yes.